Okay. Here we are. Now, regular Wednesday night class. Wednesday night, February 16th, 2011. Topic is Hulk. Or as it was known, it was Hulk. For those who aren't familiar with it, Hulk LeYisrael. Hulk LeYisrael, something that, as far as I'm concerned, I was telling my son last night, I go, what's Hulk? No idea. He's like, Hulk, Mishpat, Deen. Hulk was the item that those who learned anything would read after daily minyan. You finish saling, you read Hulk. Sometimes with explanation, sometimes without explanation. Sometimes you're not doing kines, you're taking it on the subway with you. Sometimes you're taking it to the office with you. Whatever the case was, that was it. Hulk included everything. Torah, Nibi'im, Ketubim, Mishnayot, Gemara, Zohar, Musar, and Halakha al-Ma'aseh. Period. You had everything. Every day of the week, every day of the year, you were covered. And this was done when? After praying. Lo and behold, you don't see sets of Hulk in every Knis. You don't see groups of men sitting and reading Hulk. Because everybody's coming to Knis at least an hour earlier to study Daf Yomi. That's the new thing. Well, let's go back. Let's find out something about Hulk. Let's see where it came from. What it has to do with what our Hakamim had to say about. And then we'll decide if we should go back to Hulk or not. Problem? Talk.
No, I said I'm guessing you say
it's
we
done.
Should.
It's been 8 times, by the way.
It's done, but how many people are doing it?
There's about 8 or 10 guys. Not even. Fair enough. About 8 or 10 guys. You know, what's his name? The Hazan.
Jack.
Yeah.
Basul. Not Basul.
Who? Oh,
his name,
Edward?
No.
The old guy there.
The old guy. Prince Musaf.
I have no idea.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
All right.
He's 400 miles an hour. Yeah.
I don't know B'nai Shah.
His classes in Arabic.
You know it.
I don't know B'nai Shah.
In the city, they also do folk because they have the English Hebrew one too.
Okay.
And Safra said it.
Yeah, okay. Safra. Yeah, okay. Safra. When you think of it, you let us know. All right. We're going to look at simple statement from the Hida first. Okay, we're looking at Siman Yod, Item Gimel. Aharat Filah, Yishtadel Mod Seder Hayom Be Seder Hok Li Israel. He who said in the Der Kisara, Be Kishira, Bezocheb Mad Zeman, Be Torah, Nibi'im Ketubim, Be the Shanot, Mishnah, Be Gemara, Be Zohar. והאיש הירא חוק נתן ולא יעבור כי הוא תועלת עשום לנפשו ומנהגנו שלא לקרות ביום טוב קריאת הפסוקים של השבוע שניים מקרא ואחת תרגום וסדר חוק לישראל כלל. So the Hida is telling us, after you pray, make an effort to read, to study from the order of the day, from חוק לישראל. It's a nice, clean, short method. And in a short amount of time, you're able to do all the different topics that I mentioned earlier. And the person that's Yireh Hashem, you know, don't pass this up. You know, never miss out. Because it's a great thing for your nefesh, she's telling you. And the custom is not to do it on Yom Tov. We don't do these things. Okay. Bottom line, the Hida talks about it in more than one place. If you look at the Mikorot, the sources on the bottom, you see, he talks about it in his Moreh Be'etzba. He talks about it in Mahzik Berakha. And he also writes that Maharhu would be Hayim Vital. In Sharam Mizvot, Parashat Bet Hanan, he writes the Sarikh Lizahir, Shalom Batel Bechol Yom Kibi'ut Shal Mikra, Mishnah, Talmud, Kabbalah, Ayim Kavanot Shalahim. Okay, you shouldn't pass up any opportunity, and you should always have a steady routine of reading these things on a daily basis. Vesarikh Lizahir Bazim Me'od, Vehosif, Demi Shalok Kara Yom Ehad, Hagam Shalom Mahuratot Sarikh Lashlimo, איזה מועיל אלה לצורך עם שני אולם יום שחסר הבירה מעוות שלא יוכל לתיקון. So basically you should always do it, and if you miss them one day, obviously you can make it up the next day, but you still never made up for what you really missed. Your soul lost on that particular day learning all these fundamentals of Judaism. ופרטי הכוונות בקריאת הפסוקים משחוק לישראל עיון מורה בעשבה אותי. Also in the Hida, you know, in separate portions in Moreh Be'etzba, He gives different kavanot that you have to have in mind when you read the Pesukim. But that's not our concern. Ve'im bazeh, now continue. Ve'im bazeh iluk ben tamid hacham, or tamidei hachamim rather, shetunatam ummanutam. ומי שאינם אלא קובעים עיתים לתורה והחיוב ללמוד בכל יום מקרא משנה ותמוד וזוהר הוא חיוב לכל אשר בשם ישראל יכונה כמבואר בשאר המזבור שם. So what's the Hidah telling us? That it makes absolutely no difference if you're the world's greatest rabbi or the simplest person. This is the reading for everybody. Everybody has to do it, because that's where you cover all these arenas. ומה גם דעל הרוב התלמידי החכמים אינם עוסקים בכל יום בפרדס חלקי תורתנו הקדושה. As a general rule, if the Hacham does not sit and read Chok, he does not read the Pardes, the entire orchard of the Torah, Peshat, Rem, Derash, and Sod, and all the different portions of the Torah, because Rov, Iyonam, Talmudam, Hubashas, Poskim, Vein Bo Chelik, Tanakh, Vizor, HaKadosh Kelal. Because most of the time, the Hacham is studying what? Gemara and Poskim. Because he needs to know how to cut the deen for people that are asking them questions. But otherwise, they wouldn't be looking at Torah, Nibi'in, Ketubim, Zohar, or other things. Ubesed HaChok LeYisrael, HaKol Mukhan Umtukkan, Besed HaMadrega, Besed HaAliyot, HaOlamot, Belezin HaIllain. Bottom line is, the Hida is pushing it, and not only the coming from the Hida, but he's telling you it goes further back to Maharhu behind Vital. The next page is a introduction, if you will, to Chok Yisrael. It appears in some editions of Chok, and it's also by the Hida. Okay, we're not going to read the entire. We're not going to read the entire first paragraph. Okay, so we'll start from the Aleph. That he mekam ki kavanosh pesu midi yom yom zot lefnim al sefer hukka ta'uba midbar. Now, ikara kavanot him lo sadeku yahdav kifi kedbeh kodesh amitiyim de shechi heberis misraim bahar kodesh yerushalayim. כתובים באצבע הרב מונן הרב שמואל ויטל והדברים העתיקים תארת יד הקודש מול אביו מונן הרב חיים ויטל. ולכן כשנתפס הספר הלז בווניסיה שם נמצאתי אנוכי איש סעיר ומסעתי ביד מעט הגביר המפיס אהובנו נוסח הכוונות ככל הנמצא איתי שהבאתי מעיר הקודש בירושלים ומעט הגביר יקירנו המדפיס הנזכר הדפיסם בסוף הדף בפני עצמו בשם משחי דבקני הם מפתירים. But I'm not just telling you, because when they first started printing the Chok books, they were putting in the different kavanot for the different pesukim, different kavanot for the different days, and he found that they weren't necessarily 100% correct. They didn't really fall in line with the writings of Maharshu and Maharhu. So he had with him, when he was in Italy, in Venice, he had the kavanot that he brought with him from Yerushalayim, and he gave it to the printer, and the printer ended up adding it in the next version as an addendum at the end of the book. Yan, ki asifra kadosh allaz masul lakol, ve'elu kavanot lo itachinu lehamon ha'am, begam nimi she'enlu hathala b'chokmat ha'emet, ולכן בספר הזה הושמטו הכוונות אשר נכתבו בכל יום דלב כל מוכר סביל דה. He said all these כוונות are all great, but they're not for the average human being, and Chok is for the regular person. Everybody reads Chok, and it's not for Hamon Am, and it's not even for the person who's first beginning in Chokmat HaEmet, in other words in Kabbalah and Zohar. Therefore, from this book, from this printing, we have eradicated, removed all the kavanot of each day, because not everybody's brain can handle it. Umagam, kiloy b'sar mehamat et pesatam b'chol yom ta'oyot et defus v'el debarim ha'omdim b'romo sh'olam. And guaranteed, because the people that are printing, they don't really understand it, and guaranteed there's going to be mistakes in the kavanot. And these are things that the kavanot, if they're done the right way, for those who understand it, they really are on top of the world. And if you put them in the wrong way, they're just messing things up. من بسود دفع حب تحلات كل حوم بتحلات كل حوماش كفيه فنش حدف كنيد السكار. So we just printed at the beginning of each parasha the kavanot. For those who need them, they know how to find them. והשילו יד ושם בסוד השם. נקל להם לחזור בנועם ולחווה מכל יום ודף הזה עיניהם ישיתו לעשות כבנים למלך השמיים הביא זוהורים. בכל יום צריך קרוא מקרא פסוקי תורה שני פעמים ואחת תרגום ופסוקי נביאים וכתובים פעם אחת מקרא ופעם אחת תרגום יושבים וקוראים. אז every day you have to read. What are we reading? You're reading מקרא. מקרא meaning Torah. Torah, you read Pasuk, you read that same Pasuk a second time, and then you read the Targum of it. When you finish the Pasukim of the day, then you go on to the Nebi'im. Nebi'im, you read the Pasuk once, and the Targum once. Then you go on to Ketubim, Ketubim Pasuk once, and Targum once. So only the Pasukim of the Torah, you're reading Pasukim twice. Okay? If you see, you take a book of Hawk out, standard format, you had the Pasuk, you read it again, you have the Targum. It went around the table, everybody got to read two Pasukim generally, you know, and everybody got to learn Ta'amim as well, or to brush up on the Ta'amim on things that you weren't reading before. Because besides reading the Torah that everybody knows, and it's broken up by the order of the week, generally you have about six Pasukim for Monday, for Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, you get a few extra. Then there's Pesukim for Friday and for Friday afternoon, and different things. Then you have the Nibi'im usually going with the order of the Haftarah. The Ketubim, they would start from a certain area that has some connection to the, either to the Parasha or to the Haftarah. And then as far as the Mishnayot and Gemara tried to do, Rabbi Yitzhak Baruch, who compiled and first printed Hawk in 1740, the first publishing of it, he tried to put in order where on Sunday it would be something from Zera'im, and then on Monday from Sayyidina Mu'ayyid, and then from, on Tuesday from Sayyidina Hashim. Each day you have something, and that way over the course of the year you've gone basically through the entire Shishadri Mishnah. The Gemara would be connected in some way to that. The Zohar has something to do with the Parasha. And that's where it ended. When the Hidah came along, you'll see later on, I think we'll talk about it coming up soon, he saw all this was great, but it's not enough, because bottom line is, we all need Musar. We need to get some ethics to go, because everybody's going out to work right after that. And you need, you know, some ethics to remind you how to behave with people. And Halakha Pisuka, clear-cut Halakha. And what did he choose for Halakha? Only Harambam. He only put Halakha from Harambam. This is the Hidah. There's somebody who lived, obviously, more than 200 years after Shulchan Aruch. Shulchan Aruch was already widely accepted. He, the Hidah himself, wrote numerous volumes on Halakha, but he chose Harambam because it was clear, cut, concise Halakha that everybody can relate to and applicable in the cases that he chose.
Was this post his visit to Egypt or pre?
What was what post his visit to Egypt?
His decision to put Harambam in the...
Let's see if he talks about when he did it. Okay. You'll find out. And he didn't visit. He actually was chief rabbi for 5 years.
Good. In his larger life,
it's not a visit. I'm sorry. When you have a post of chief rabbi for 5 years, it's not a visit. No, no. A visit could be a year. But in that, in their time period, a year, you visited.
So Chacham Avadiyah visited, or he didn't visit Egypt?
Chacham Avadiyah was a bit dean for 3 years. He didn't visit. No. How could you call it a visit? Explain.
Well, I meant like his through. He was going from place to place, and this was one of the stops.
Wait. No, we're going back to the Hidah or to Chacham Avadiyah now?
The Hidah.
The Hidah was going all over the place. He was an emissary for the Holy Land.
Agreed.
Great. He showed up, they wouldn't let him go. He was staying. Yod, bedefusim, shekadmu, ma'anyan ha-mishnayot ve-gemara, yesh hasir halif yatir, ve-chem ma'amari ha-zor ha-kadosh, ve-yam ha-ilib rab ala-itam. Because in the earlier printings, especially when the Mishnayot and the Gemara, there were things that were missing, things that were wrong, things that were added. Even in the statements of the Zohar, all types of outside comments were thrown in, because now we fixed it all, everything is straight, everything is clear, you can rely upon it. Yod Aleph. Gam nitpaz zot lefanim b'sefer hazeh b'reshit ma'amar Imrei Kadosh, Morin Harab Haim Vital, Velashonahu, Leslik Shapir, Kati Begevaya, Ezli Barim Shishin, Wolfia Kitabin Hamitim, Ilazot Shmat, Mechita Van of Shechada de Barim Shoshan, Puk, Ayen, Bisharim's vote, she said Harab, Morin Harab, Shmuel Vital, Rajat Akib, Mushana Shemot, the Sever Osrot Hayim, Sever Es Hayim, Hayesebehem, Musham, Beraz Kukin, Neura, Beurin, goes all again. Also, early older versions, they added all these extra writings of Moreno Harab Haim Vital Maharhu. All these things, we've moved them out. They really don't play a role for the people that are reading Harp on a daily basis. If you're one of those people that you're so steeped in Kabbalah and you need to know these things, great, go to the book Shah Hamzvot, sit down, read, study, wonderful. It's not part of Harp. Yod Bet. עוד, הוסיפו מעלת המגיהים שימורים לכל בני ישראל, מאמרי גמרא וזוהר, איפה הם רועים? הגיעו את פרקן בעלים רדפים כאשר הייתה באומנה, ועוזות יתרה היד קודמת, ומתה דעתה מתחתה. Again, anything that he found superfluous, anything that wasn't needed, he removed. Now, יוסף לחוק. Musa Melachim v'halacha pesuka yom liyom yabia debarim hammehavverim. Because this is the part that I added. I saw the need to add a section. So I called it Yosef Lehok. This is Yosef Haim Yosef David Azulai. His original name was Yosef, and as when he was sick later on, they added the name Haim to him. So he's Yosef and Lehok to the Hok. Is Musa and halacha for each day. Things that are simple, things that are easy, things that are applicable. בסור ישראל ישראל משגיאו ויעילו מתורתו נפלאות בשגואל ויעילה מתו שבשחות ובסדק סדק דחרין ואמרין כי ירסון. Very good. So bottom line is, he ends it over here. This is the importance of Hulk. This is what we looked with to clean it up. There were a lot of mistakes, bottom line, and we added things that we found to be necessary for each person. Next page, it's a little bit lengthy. We'll see how much we're going to read from it. Rabbi Yaakov Raqqah. Rabbi Yaakov Raqqah was a very, very big rabbi in Tripoli, Libya. He was very, very interesting in the fact that when the Hachamim in Italy and the book publishers in Italy, you know, had their choice of every rabbi from around the world would come to them with things, you know, to print and ideas and concepts. Many times, the publishers and printers went directly to Rabbi Yaakov Raqqah. We want your introduction. We want your Hiddushim for this particular book we're going to publish. Even though it's somebody else's book, or it's a general book, we want you to give us this introduction. And it wasn't the author who went to them, it was the publishers. Because they knew that he knew how to put everything into a perfect form. And
what's the time? When was he?
1800s, late 1800s. Mm-hmm. He passed away maybe 1870. Mm-hmm. I can double check if we need to know, but we'll check it later. So this is his introduction to the Hulk. And his introduction to Hulk was originally not published in a Hulk, but originally he published it in his book Sha'ari Tefillah. Sha'ari Tefillah is a book where he discusses different concepts of prayer, and especially halachot and minhagim of prayer, as well as variant readings of words in the prayer. Different nusha'ot, different diktukim, things like that. And of course, at the end of the prayer section of Shahrit, boom, Hauk LeYisrael, right in there. And here it is. Muda'at zo'at b'hayyub talmud Torah, v'chmo shikatav at-tur, ומרן ולבוש וירדיעה והרמב״ם מלכות תלמוד תורה וזה לשונו כל איש ישראל חיה בתלמוד תורה בן עני בן עשיר בן שלם בגופו בן בעל יסורים בן בחור בן זקן גדול ואפילו עני המחזר על פתחים אפילו בעל אישה ובנים חיה בקבוב ועלו זמן לתלמוד תורה ביום ובלילה שנאמר ויגיד בו יום ולילה. Bottom line, he's telling you, he's proclaiming this. There is a hiyub of Torah upon everybody. You want to go by the tour? He says it. You want to follow Maran? He says it. You want to follow the Bush? He says it. You want to follow Harambam? He says it. Boom. And then he goes to quote who? Harambam. Every man of Israel is obligated to Torah. Poor, rich, healthy, not healthy, young, old, whether you're going and knocking on people's doors, you know, to get money, whether you're a family man and you have a wife and kids and you have things to do, every person has an obligation to establish for himself set times of learning Torah day and night. Torah says, "V'hagita mo yomam v'alayla." V'hayab v'shalish limudo. Shalish b'Torah shebichtav. The Hainum Arba'a V'Islim. Notice how it's Arba'a V'Islim. It's not called the Tanakh. Okay, it was always called by Sefaradim Arba'a V'Islim. Shalish B'Mishnah. The Hainum Torah Sheba'al Peh. Okay, Mishnah does not mean necessarily what we know as the book called Mishnah, but it's Torah Sheba'al Peh. U'Pirush Torah Shebichtav Bichlal Zeh. In other words, understanding Torah Shebichtav, different Pirushim, whether you want to talk about Rashi, you want to talk Ibn Ezra, you want to talk Seforno, you want to talk Haskuni, all that is part of the Mishnah field. And Shalish B'Talmud. Talmud, he's not even getting into what Talmud is, but Talmud generally means Halakha Pesuka. Okay, so you have to take your Limud and split it into thirds. Third in Torah Shebichtav, third in Mishnah, and a third in Talmud. Kesad, how? Haya Ba'al Umarut, Ve'oseg Naftor. Yeah, you're a man of profession. You work for 3 hours, 9 hours you sit and study Torah. Kore shelosha mehem b'Torah shebichtav. 3 hours sit and just read Torah. Torah shebichtav, obviously. B'shelosha Torah shebaal peh. Then 3 hours Torah shebaal peh, and then shelosha yevin davar mitoch davar. Begam be'or hayim b'tur. Maran, Lebush, Chikatu, Ahashi, Yesevet, Kenesi, Erechavet, and Midrash. We have a halakha and Shuharuf. Okay, Siman Kuf Nun He. Right after he finishes in Chot Shahrid and everything, and Alin Shabbeh and all, you have an obligation. Once you finish the Kines, go straight, take a walk, go straight to the Beit Midrash. Go sit and study Torah. Beikba Ait Lmod. Mesarik Shoto Ait Ye Kabua. Shaloya Averinu. You have to have a set established time and you have to stick to it, even if you think, no, I gotta go today, I can't make it because I have a big business deal this morning. No, you gotta go study first, have your set time, this is your allotted time, whatever it is, from 7 to 8, from 7 to 7:02, you have a set time, you gotta stick to it every day. ומהחשיקן שחייב כל איש לעסוק בתשעה שעות ביום בתלמוד תורה. אם כן, מה יעני האדם ביום הדין לפני המלך וכן מלך יבקש ברוך הוא, שכל היום כולו עוסק מלאכתו ואיש איש על עבודתו ואינו עוסק בתורתו, כי ודאי אין קש לעונשו, ואם ראו תראה, מה אמר משנה רבתה, אשר הבאתי בקונטוס מיני מרקחת, שבסוף ספר נחמד מעשה לוקח של מוזקני, ושם בפרק שלי שהבאתי כל המאמר באורך, ועליכת לחזיר משנים, שכל קורא בהם תסבל שערות לשרו, ולא יאכל ולא ישתה בראותו שכל מה שקרה לא נחשב לו כלום, שצריך לקרוא כל מה שכתוב שם, ויש מה טוב יכפר בעל. So the bottom line is, if you have an obligation, if you're working 3 hours, you have to learn the 9 hours, what are you going to do when you know when you try to fudge it all, and you come before Borei Olam, wait and see what's going to happen to you. And they tell you, okay, the story, this, that, I'm not, you know, go check it out over there, I'm not going to get into it. Hine, תיכן מזבח על כל איש אשר בשם ישראל יכונה לקנו לו ספר חוק לישראל לקרוא בו בכל יום. There's a mitzvah, he's telling you.
Wow.
On each and every member of Am Yisrael, every man, go out and buy a book of Chok. and read it every day. She was said that Na'ev Ya'esh Ken Lanu Haraba Kadosh Tanaha Elohi Ha'ari. Yay answer Sion. Good. This is a well established order that was established for us by who? None other than the Ari. Binu Ishaq Luriya Ashkenazi. Asheb Bikriato Zoche Bima'at Qat Bishloshal Mulim. Nothing. Wink of an eye. Boom! You learned everything. All three things. Shalish bin Mikra, Torah Nabi Miktuhim. Shalish bin Mishnah, Shkore Perik Meha Mishnah. Shalish bin Gemara, Shkore Paskeh Meha Gemara. Binusab Gam, Ma'amal Mezor HaKadosh. And you'll see that some Zohar too. Bishamati Rimz Na'eki, Bikriyat Chok Lisa'el, Sham Ramuz Taryag, Ki Tanakh, Torah Nabi Miktuhim, Mishnah, Gemara, Kabbalah, Shuazor, Vashit Tevot Shalahim, Gematriyat Taryag. Look at the end of the Rashi Tevot of all these things. It comes out to 613, he's telling you.
And Bam says Mizvah also?
No, obviously, Bam doesn't say Mizvah also. He's telling you, the way he reads Mizvah, he doesn't mean that it's Mizvah, it's one of the 613 Mizvahs, right. But in Mizvah, you have an obligation to learn Torah. So here you go, obligation. Go out and get yourself a harp and cover your bases. What are you doing? Unless you're sitting there and you have a stack of books.
Like it's lost.
Well, it wasn't lost in 1970. It wasn't lost in 1980. It was still there.
And?
Poor Sitchell. Still there.
With
Sitchell, every Shabbat.
Shabbat, you don't do chok. Nobody does chok on Shabbat. Nobody does chok on Shabbat.
We read before. Shabbat, Yom Tov.
No chok on Shabbat. Chok is Sunday through Friday.
Every morning then.
Sunday through Friday.
Sunday through Friday.
Except when Yom Tov.
Well, obviously we're saying not Shem, and not Chol HaMoed either.
Mishmarah on Shabbat.
Mishmarah Shabbat afternoon, Torah, Nevi'im, Ketuvim, and Mishnah. Okay. And if you were on the forum when we discussed it way back when, you'd know more about it.
Was it before it was separated or after?
What do you mean by separated?
The hasanuforum.com or the 100 emails a day one?
No, not on the 100 emails a day. On the website, it's still there.
Okay.
We're still running, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's be honest now. Because most people are not going to sit and learn 9 hours a day. Okay?
Really?
He's honest. Why? Because he's busy what? Supporting who? His wife. Right? First he does right. He doesn't like himself. He does right away. His wife. And his kids and himself. It's always us that comes last. Okay? Take the book. Take it with you to work. Read it. Between customers, whatever the case may be.
On the train.
Nowadays, most of the people, they have a head on their shoulders, they understand something, and even the hachamim, after they finish, they still want to let the tefillin and sit down and they read it. Ashrehev ashreh halkam. In a short amount of time, you finish everything. Like we read how much?
10 minutes.
Nothing. 6 minutes. Nothing. How long does it take to read? The Krot, Torah, Nibiim, Ketuvim, the Shalom, Mishnah, Gemara, Zohar. Nothing. Generally, I would say it takes about 15 minutes. But okay, if you want to sit down and read, you know, to try to understand it. You know, if you want to have a class, you can have a class. Have a class for an hour reading Hulk. ואיש הירח חוק נתן ולא יעבור כי הוא תורעת עסום לנשור כי יהיה נאמנה הזאת נעומי וגם ילמוד כל הנתונים בתרגום כמו שכתב הארי זה יחסית לברכה וגם לא יאמר תפילות של ראש הספר. What? Look what he ends up. Hey, you're learning all these things. No, you don't want to feel it. But don't say all the prayers at the beginning of the book. Okay? Like the Hida said, we cut off all this extra stuff. Because that's not really what it's about. Okay? It's really about learning the different portions. It's not about the Kavanot. It's not about the prayers. It's not about, you know, the extra mystical stuff. It's about learning Torah. And it's about having a set order where you fulfill your obligation, where you cover all your bases, where Torah Shebichtav is not thrown to the wayside because we need to do Daf Yomi. Gama hara v'chzik b'shebach kiri'ah zo rabah hasid chesed alafim. Chesed alafim is b'de Ezer Papo, who also wrote about this. Ahar she'isim b'de keneset v'chuleh v'hin atan pashet limud seder hauk l'Yisrael. He writes, after we finish praying, what's the thing nowadays? Hauk. ומתור שהתלמיד החכם או יהודי יעסף שבעי יקרא אותו בקול רב מתון. Because what? The תלמיד החכם, the החכם that's there, or the guy who knows how to read and understand and explain, or whatever the case may be, he should be the guy that starts the hawk. Okay, don't leave it for the simple guy. Let the guy who really knows, let him do the hawk, let him read it out loud, let him read it slowly, clearly. Then the people, you know, are going to come and gather towards him. Okay, they'll gravitate towards him. And they're going to learn. Finish the Gemara, and then he'll explain to them the Gemara and the Zohar and the Musar. You know, the Yosef Lechok, the Halacha. Whoever wants to merit will be privileged. Even the simplest of people. Vayin gam harab devash lefi. Devash lefi is another book of the Hida. The Hida in that particular section, I looked it up online because I don't have this book. He goes wild in that section in devash lefi, you know, talking about how important it is, you know, to study the Hok and understand what's going on and to get a Hok teacher, in fact. V'seder kriyat pesukim shel haseder hazeh, hineh hinnam. He goes, the order of the Pesukim has been laid out. We know what they are. We know where to find the sources. If somebody wants to go and make their own Hok book, you know, because you don't want to go buy it or you can't find it, go look up the other sources and copy, and you'll know how to, you know, what the exact order of that should be in Hok every day. So really, there's not, even though the section about Rabbi Yaakov Raka has much longer, but again, he talks about different kavanot and what to do on holidays, what not to do on holidays, things like that. Things that, again, excuse me, not applicable to what we're reading right now. Now we're going to jump into a more modern period. Kaf Hayim Sofer, not Kaf Hayim Padashi. Kaf Hayim Sofer, originally Kaf Hayim Sofer from Baghdad, who went to Yerushalayim, and he wrote his commentary on Shuharuch Orachayim. So, in Siman Qof Lamed Bet, you have a section, Hesef Katan Vav. And we're not going to read the first paragraph, but we're going to start from the second section, Veda'a. You see it? Second paragraph? Mm-hmm. Second column. Vida'a. Vida'a ki sarikh likrot. Kol illo pesukim kide shikurin perasha ve'ay shabbat. Kol pesuk mehem. Shalayim mikra ve'hatargum. What is this? Some sort of printing mistake. Gam, okay, also no. She even look at him, Yom Bet. She Kra Bet, Kiriot, etc., etc. Then you can actually, okay, so in all the Kiriot, very good. Be Hakach. You crave any being, the Hopasuk may him, you crave Pamahat, the Kra, Pamahat, the Goom, the Haka, he crave Ktubim, Emmeter Goom Shilahim, Haka, he crave, and say that his car Mishnah Betel Mood, the Hule, Ube the Lord, is a little more to give you what is it, Omnam the Barianian, the Shishi, the Fee, Shiga, Bos, a little Krom Kra. So he's telling you all the different times you have to read these different sections, and he's going to talk about on Fridays, late Thursday night, early Friday morning, is the only time they could read Mikra at night. You could only read 26 Pesukim. Again, all of Pi HaSod, And we're not really concerned with all that. Then he's going to go on to the next page. No, we're not. We're not concerned about the sword. Okay? Then he's going to go into different orders of Pesukim. So we're going to skip all that, and now we're going to go to Siman Kof Nun He. Kof Nun He is where Shohanuch has the Siman of going to exiting the Beit Knesset and going to the Beit Midrash. You see, Ahar Shi Yaseh Beit Knesset. Everybody has it?
Yeah.
Ahar Shi Yaseh Beit Knesset. Yelech Beit Midrash Veyikba' Et Lmud. Okay? Fine. So now on the bottom, he talks in Gimel. Veyikba' Et Lmud. Everybody has it?
Yeah.
Vechetab Or Torah Ot Rishon. הוא לומד הורה נביאים כתובים ומשנה וגמרא וזוהר הקדוש ומוסר ודינים. Right, in a short amount of time, right after prayer, you're able to cover all the all grounds. You have Torah and Kinnin, three things over there. The Mishnah Gemara, another two things. The Zohar, you're already up to three, four, five, six things. And Musar and Dinim, eight items you covered. Bikavar katabnu haseder shesarich lomod al pi debrei ha'ari. That's what we read before, but we skipped over all the kavanot and all the issues. Again, I'm not into, you know, I can only learn six pesukim now and then six pesukim later. I have to have this kavanah. Again, that's for people that are in that realm. You know, that's for them. But for me, if I could cover, you know, Shai Mekrabi Hatargum and I could cover Hawk, I'm golden. Hey, Omer Zeh Seder B'Shehen La'ari uses Haya Omer Zeh Seder B'Shesir Tiflin B'Hen Katab M'La'il V'Ayinun Shah. And if you can wait till the Tiflin when you do it, obviously it's very good. And go and read. Here we go. Betob Shatamid Hacham O Yodei HaSefer Shiba'ir Yikre HaChok B'Kol Ram Metun Ve'Elav Yasefu Kol Yirei Hashem. Exactly what we read from Be'Yakob Rakah Ve'Chol Yishimu Ve'Yidmedu Aharav Ve'Yifarish Lehem HaGemara Ve'Hazor Imhu Metu HaChot Musar Ve'Yosef LaChok Lefim. Everything exactly what we read before, the Kaf Haim is just quoting it. And there doesn't seem to be anybody arguing. So until we're getting to Kaf Hayim, when he's first printing in the early 1930s, okay, and it was subsequently reprinted and reprinted again, nobody argued. That's what everybody did. Either you stayed and you did it, or you just left. You know, but there were always some people staying, and there was definitely nobody coming and doing what they're doing today. Okay, whether people that came much earlier than time for prayer and did other things, yes, there were bakashot for during the week also. That people in the frame of mind, not bakashot in the frame of singing, but bakashot that they would, you know, just to focus, you know, before prayer. There were people that were sat and read Zohar before the prayer. Again, to get themselves into the frame of mind. There were people that read Musar. There were always people that did different things, but what we're seeing nowadays, you know, let's only do this new Daf Yomi thing, something that was only recently established in Eastern Europe. Yeah, we're running. It's good. Let it run. That's important. Yes. Something that was only started in Eastern Europe about, what, 100 years ago, 150 years ago, Maki? Daf Yomi, when did it start?
I'm ignorant.
You're ignorant.
Totally
okay.
Ishkenaz,
I understand, but you know, you went to.
I'm not a big guy for me.
You went to quote unquote yeshiva. Maybe you know.
It seems like it's widespread in the Sephardic community today.
Again, like we talked about earlier, because a person has a Sephardic last name doesn't mean they're Sephardic.
No.
Okay? No, it's something to think about.
The last name could be Ashkenazi.
Right. One nice point of the Daf Yomi is
what?
Who was that?
Rabbi Nissim. if one Jew in one area...
He has to give a class next week. So.
David wanted to make a point about the Daf
Yomi. The only good part of the Daf Yomi is a Jew in one part of the world and a Jew in another part of the world are learning the same topic at the same time.
You know what? Everybody was reading Chok.
The whole world. Also?
Yeah, Ashkenazim also.
What's your point?
No, I said the only nice part of that is that they could... They have something in common.
Ashkenazim were also learning Chok. And
you discuss something, you start business, you discuss Torah with ladies, you see what
and recently
is,
and in Israel...
You from that, and you discuss
recently,
the
I'm on
the
list, 10 years, even less, a whole bunch of, you know, real... Old time, you know, Haredi Ashkenazim, you know, started putting up, you know, signs all over the place, you know, how it's disgusting how people have abandoned Chok LeYisrael and we need to reintroduce Chok and bring it back. And that's even among Ashkenazim now.
Well, I'm guessing you have
Amen. It. On the internet, you could see it.
What were you going to say, though?
So, tell me, David, that what's so nice is that you and me, everybody's learning the same thing.
No, I said that part is the only... Yeah.
What's wrong with the Parashah of the week?
I didn't know that.
And
the Haftarah
of the week. And Mishnayot that pertain...
So far, every comment we had was always a Sephardic rabbi on the Chok.
Well, I'm only going to be looking at Sephardic rabbis, right?
Okay.
Very good.
He has a very limited library.
Very.
I think some Ashkenazim are learning.
No, I don't know if they learned it or not. He's saying that they did.
Yes, they did.
So I couldn't have known that.
No, you couldn't have known that. I didn't know it before this morning when I found the sources for it.
Wow.
So some preparation. Okay. Next section. I'll make another... Next thing is a question from the book Is Hagir Anen. Is Hagir Anen... Helik Rishon, Shailot Shuot, Rabbi Yishak Barda. Rabbi Yishak Barda.
Did Sam send you
anything? He lives. There's enough from Sam, no. Sam did not send me any material, even though I was hoping he would. I believe he lives in Tiberia or Safed. He's up north someplace in Israel. His origin is from that world of Djerba, Tunisia.
Mm-hmm. Kohen?
Did I say he's a Kohen?
I'm asking.
Did I say he's a Kohen?
I don't remember.
Good, he's not a Kohen. Because if you're from Djerba and you're a Kohen, your last name is Kohen. That's why I made sure to say Tunisia Djerba, not Djerba Tunisia. Because Djerba Tunisia, you would think he's from Djerba, comma Tunisia. Tunisia Djerba is that general encompassing rabbinic world. Don't come late next time.
I have nothing to do with that.
Because I was expecting somebody else to come knocking at that time.
I know.
All right. So he has an interesting teshuvah. Again, we're not going to need to read the entire teshuvah. But his teshuvah, he wrote it in the end of 1970. Okay. You see that, Abby? He wrote this teshuvah at the end of 1970, okay? The winter of the 70-71 season. And he added to it later on. Im yesh hayub l'mot chok l'Yisrael. Is there an obligation to study chok? Nesh'alti mitamit hacham echad. Odot ha-minhag l'kro b'chol yom chok l'Yisrael. U'b'leil shishi kavva fisuki mikra. אם חייב כל אדם לנהוג כן, אם כן, כיסד ואימתי. בהניני להשיבו בשיחת הדשמיה. So the question came from a hacham, or a talmid hacham at the very least, regarding the custom of reading Chok on a daily basis, and on Thursday night, 26 Pesukim of Mikra. If this is an obligation upon every person, and if so, how is it done, and when is it done? دع شمنهاج زي مكورو مربينو هاري على البيا سود كم بوار بشارهم بزبوط بزي دي شنو وعبتاني بقى سيدر عشق تراشي عشق هادام بخل يوم بإني إن أنو مدبرين بخل عشق تراشي هادام عسي رب الموت كبوع شديق للموت بخل يوم بكي بيعود بسود كبعات كبسود كبعت عجيمة تورا So look at the wording from Sharam Mizvot. He says that they were going to explain and lay out for you the order of toiling in Torah, working in Torah. That every person should be working, you know, or in that realm of Torah on a daily basis. And he says, we're not talking about all the Torah that you have to learn, only with limud kabua, with a set, established learning that you must do every day to fulfill what? Kabata itim Torah. That you establish set times for studying Torah. Vizehu min had muri zal. Okay, so he's writing, this is obviously Maharhu is writing, and he's saying, this is the custom of my master, of the Ali. Ahasha'e yosim bitkeneset. Vo'ochel achilato. Haya mit'atteb isisit vilobesh tefillin. Okay, he finished praying, took off the tefillin, he left kines, he went to eat, okay, and now he put on the tefillin again. Bahaka. Korea Kriya has so shit Bair Abta Tahillai Kriya Mikra Torah Bihaka Nabiim Bihaka Kitubim Bihaka Kabbalah Bihaka Mishnah Bihaka Talmud. Different order than what's in the Hawk today. Slightly different. Beto Shikri Shiloshe Behinot Shishba Talmud Behem Beraita Tosefta Umimra. And it's good when you're reading in the Gemara, three different forms that are within the Talmud. Right, Maki? You have Beraita, Tosefta, and Mimra. B'ne'ele aniyud da'ati, sh'akabbalat yiyye ba'ahrona mikullam. And it would seem to me that Kabbalah should be at the end of them all. And that's what we have in our Hawk today, that the Kabbalah is at the end. We have Torah and Miktubim, then we have Mishnah Gemara, and then we have the Kabbalah. Lefi shesedra madrigot mimatta lemaala. Okay, he's saying that we are going in an orderly progression from the lowest up to the highest. So he's calling Torah the lowest. Torah shebichtav, and he's saying Nibim is higher than that, Ketuvim is higher than that. That's the way he's looking at it, and he's working all the way up to the Zohar. Lefi shesedra madrigot mimatta lemaala hemat halima mikra musayim bekabbalah. וזהו דרך פרעתה. תחילה יקרה פרשת השבוע, ההיא, ביום ראשון יקרה שישה פסוקים ראשונים שבאותה פרשה. Okay? So on the first day, on Sunday, you read six פסוקים of the פרשה. ביום השני יקרה ארבעה פסוקים. The next day, you read four פסוקים. And then on Tuesday and on Thursday. Okay? Tuesday, five פסוקים. And then on Wednesday, another six pesukim. And then on Thursday, five pesukim. Uklana kullam hem kavva pesukim. Okay, that adds up and you have 26 pesukim, right?
Yeah.
Good. Shem Hashem. Veda'a. Ki salich lekrot kol elua pesukim kedir shikoreh parasha. Ba'alu Shabbat, kol pesuk mehem shalai mikra v'hatargum. Right, you read it like you would read on Erev Shabbat and fulfill the obligation of Shai Mekra B'Hatargum. You have to do the same way. Read the Pasuk twice and then Targum once. Be'harkach yikre b'nibi'im. Kod Pasuk, Shai Mekra B'Hatargum. U'masadik etu b'kontrusi shebechod Pasuk mehem yikre pa'am ahar Mekra u'pa'am ahatargum. Harkach yikre b'tuvim ahatargum shalahim. So like we said before, only the Torah is two times the Pasuk, but for Nibi'im k'tuvim, only one time the Pasuk. Be'harkach yikre al-sedah and iskar mishnah b'talmud. ובלילות אין צריך ללמוד כביעות הזה. And at night, you don't have to learn this set learning. עד כאן לשונו. Okay, that's the extent of his wording. ורבותינו הצדיקים תקנו לומר את הסדר על פי דברי הארי וקראו אותו חוק לישראל. And our חכמים established this reading according to the ארי, they call it חוק לישראל. ומרן החידה בא והוסיף עליו דברי המוסר בכמה פסקי הלכה. And the חידה came and he added to the מוסר and the הלכה, he called that section יוסף לחוק. ומעתה הבו נבוא לדברי הארי והנה ידוע שיש חיוב לקבוע עתים כמו שכתוב קבעת עתים לתורה. ורבינו הארי גילה ברוח קודשו שסוד זה הוא לקרוא כמה פסוקי תנ"ך משנה ותלמוד וקבלה שהם כוללים את כללות תורתנו הקדושה, פרדס את תורתנו הקדושה, ובזה משלים חוקו היומיומי. And the Ari came and he you know, uncovered this great thing for us, and he showed us how we're able to complete our obligation on a daily basis. ולכן ראוי לכל ישראל לקבוע סדר כדי שלא יגרע להם חוקו שהוא סורך נפש רוח נשמה שלו. ועל פי שראיתי למורנו הרב הגאון הראשון לציון שליטה בספר כל סיני. Okay, he's talking about how much you said. This is again, we're talking about the end of 1970. There was no writings of the Chamoji other than Yabi Omer. Even this Yalkut Yosef in 1971 wasn't out yet. Right. His writings were all in Kol Sinai. Kol Sinai was a monthly Torah journal that used to come out. We got a whole bunch of them inside. We'll show you later. Okay, so he's telling you Amud 316. He's not telling you what month or what year. He's just telling you page 316. We'll show you what he's talking about after.
Sorry, this is the Chamoji.
No, he's mentioning. He goes, and even though I saw, Rabbi Yitzhak Barda is telling you, even though I saw that Chamoji, the Rishon LeZion, okay, writes in Kol Sinai, page 316, Shekatab, Shetalmid Hacham, Shetorato Ummanuto, Eno Hayab, Bekiriat Hokli Israel, that Chamoji is saying that Talmid Hacham, who Torah is his profession, he has no obligation to read Chok. Okay, and he fulfills the obligation of his reading a third of each thing just by praying, if he prays everything from the beginning, obviously, because you have everything, especially in the beginning part. Diskin. Okay, and he relies upon Maharid Diski and Shubab Shalat Hayim Zunenfeld Beheskim Imo, etc. He's relying upon these two big Ashkenazi Hachamim, Rabbi Diskin and Rabbi Zunenfeld. Mikom Mako Omen Ani Shalabinu Ha'ari Yada Bishilush Neskir Dayed. Because I'm sorry, the Ari knew about how to pray. Okay, because basically the way we're praying is basically based upon the Ari nowadays, right? All this extra stuff. So the Ari was familiar with it, and he didn't rely on it. Ma'al kol ze amar she sod kaba'at ha'ikim ha'Torah who was said in Eskid Ve'il, he established this way of learning. V'la'anyu da'ati en ra'uy l'tamidei ha'chamim she yehassiru mesed Eskid Ve'il she en bo illa asara rega'im. And as far as I can tell, there's no reason for any ha'cham to do away with Chok, because the whole thing takes 10 minutes.
Do away with it.
He said, Rabbi Yitzhak Barda, saying, I see no reason why any Talmid Hacham should do away with Chok, because all of Chok takes 10 minutes, you go into the Ari, you're fulfilling all the obligations and everything. What's the problem? ובפרט שהארי מגלה שבזה הוא מתקן נפש רוח ושמה שלו, תיקון הראוי להם. Because you are, if you want to call it, fixing, you know, your nefesh, ruach, and shema by doing it. So what's the problem? ולכן, מכאן ולהבא, חוש בינה טובה, שכל תלמידי החכמים, ישתדלו לקרוא קריאה זו. שכר מזווה, מזווה. ואין עובי של שעות, יביע עומר, חלק דל. This is my opinion. I think every hacham has to do it, and every person must do it. Bottom line, you want to go read more about it from a hacham, go see his yabiya omer. Done. And he ended it at that point.
Some of Jeb's relying on who these two?
Ashkenazi rabbis. That, Rabbi Diskin and Rabbi Zunenfeld.
That you don't need to do a halakha because if you want to fulfill...
That's where you lost it.
Because if you want to fulfill your obligation of, you know, covering all your bases,
right. Okay,
but you don't have to do a halakha. You cover all your bases in the prayer. You have Torah Shebichtav, right. You have Pesukim from the Mishnah, Pesukim from the Ketubim, you have Mishnah, do you have Gemara? You don't have Gemara, but you have Mishnah.
That's enough.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Ketoret has I wouldn't really call it a Gemara. Okay. Does it have Zohar in it? Depends what you want to add.
Right.
And then.
With Hashem Yehud.
No, he's not talking about fulfilling.
No, I know.
He's talking about being Mishalish.
He's saying Chamov and Jazz going on these two Ashkenazi rabbis.
Okay.
You covered
in
your prayer.
Now, do you have the and you have halacha? You have halacha. You have things.
Okay.
So you covered with your prayer.
No, technically.
You ask anybody today, they'll never give me that answer.
Because they don't pray.
Right.
Because they're not. They're definitely. If you're not saying the beginning, you don't have no Mishnah.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Now the question is, do you say the beginning or you don't say the beginning?
You tell him like that, you do Hulk? He says, yeah, crazy for him. Yeah, that's his answer. I covered Hulk and I'm just doing Gemara.
That's if he knows what Hulk is.
Right. Okay.
That is just, it's very, very interesting to see.
What were these two Ashkenazi rabbis? What's their.
No, a big Gish.
I'm saying, you know. What did they say on this one?
I don't have the tissue.
Oh, you didn't have?
Like they said, I have a very limited library. Oh. No, listen.
You have any
I know this kid's. Yeah, I don't know much about his writings. Zonenfeld, though, was a major hachem. He was a really very, very big rabbi in Yerushalayim. No, quite, you know.
They're dead?
They're long gone, yeah. They passed away way before this was written.
Uh-huh. It's amazing that the Chamovid Yeah would base it on.
No, it's not amazing.
Why?
Yeah.
Chamovid Yeah does
not.
You want
to pause or don't pause yet?
No, you don't have to pause. We're not saying anything.
Okay.
Chamovid Yeah. Harambam was not saying telling us to do this. It was basically the Hida. It was a B.
Much later.
Hayim Perachi.
Right.
It was B. The Isaac Purple. It was these type of Sefaradi Hachamim that were also very, very steeped in the world of Kabbalah, of Zohar, of the Ari, Mahar Shur, Ben Harashash. They were in that framework. Chacham Ovadia, you have to understand, came out publicly against many things that the Ben Ish-Hai wrote. Ben Ish-Hai was part of that same Kabbalistic world. Chaim Ovadia was looking at things a little bit differently. He was like, it's a very, very wrong way of trying to relate it, but let's say Ham compared to everybody else, okay? Very, very different, you know, way of looking at things. Hello.
Oh.
Okay.
Ham.
No. In other words, a different way of... approaching things. Basically, he came out against halacha pisuka of the Ben Ish-Hai. He said that the Ben Ish-Hai is wrong on this halacha. Ben Ish-Hai should not be followed on this point. The people went wild on him in Yerushalayim. They threatened his life. What? They burnt his books in the street. No, this is a fact.
That's funny.
They threatened the Chaim Ovadia's life.
This is so...
They attacked him. Physically, mentally, they took his writings, they had bonfires and burnt Chaim Ovadia's writings in the streets. This was a big thing. So, but what's a bigger, you know, now for this guy, in this time period, to come out and write, you know, the Gaon that he's shown the Sion, and to come out against him, that's also a very strange thing. That's not something you saw amongst the Sefaradim at such an early time period. So we have to also ask, what's going on over here? Is he part of that, you know, group of people that was already, you know, a student of the school of anti-Chaim Ovadia people?
I mean, the Baal of Yitzchak and Anan?
Yeah. Rabbi Yitzchak Barda. All right. Or was he trying to be intellectually honest with himself and say, I just don't buy the methodology? Because he calls him Moreno Harab HaGaon HaRishon LeSion, I would think that he was not one of the guys that was against him. Okay? But just interesting, because in general you didn't find Sefaradim, you know, right, attacking HaRishon LeSion. No.
Just because he's accepting the fact that he's HaRishon LeSion doesn't mean that he can't disagree. Disagree with
him. But he still has the respect.
No.
He still has the respect. He recognizes him.
Great.
As the answer.
So don't even mention it. Don't bring it up. Don't bring it up. The guy asked ABC, Mr. Joe Batich asked me a question. Here's my answer. Why do I have to bring a Chaim Ovadia's view? Why do I have to come and knock a Chaim Ovadia's view over here at this point? Something is not... No, not true. Show me some. That within the first paragraph you come in and knock on the chill and so on. Not Sefaradi style whatsoever.
I see what you're saying.
We don't see it. It's unheard of. And now let's come to explain How and when do we read? והנה מדברי העלי, הנזכרים לעיל, מבואר שצריך לקרוא את הפסוקים בתורה שניים בקרא והתרגום. ואילו פסוקי הנביא יקרא פעם אחת בקרא, פעם אחת תרגום, כפי שיעיד מהרחו שמעשה בקונטרוסו. והשמיענו זו כנראה לפי שזו האמת. ושוב ראיתי למרן החידה, בואו נראה באצבע, זה הכי סביר עליה בשיטות, וכן פסוקי כתובים, פעם אחת בקרא, פעם אחת תרגום. וכמה נתפס חוק לישראל מתוקן שבו מסודרים כל פסוקי התנ"ך עם התרגום ביניהם מהר חושן כתב עוד גם דע שאם לא קרא מקרא ביום ראשון של השבוע יש לו את השלמים שיקרא ביום שני שני מקראות פן שקריאת יום ראשון וקריאת יום בית אבל איזו מועיל רק לסורך יום בית שקריאת החילה קריאת יום שלפני לדדק אחר כך יקרא קריאת היום הוא איך לסורך יום ראשון שלא קרא בו אין לו תיקון כלל ועליו נאמר מעבד או יוכל תיקון אין כזה שלום Exactly what we read before. I'm not going to repeat it. Hare, Shadak the Sorek Oto Yom, who called it Kirat Edmund, Abalot Kunim Tmund, which was here Shmaharam, Papiras, Ketab, Tuadin, Lokara, Albayamim, Kishabo, the Krobi Yahamshi, Ketahila, Shal Albayamim, Hakahi Grace, the Yahamshi, Aka, Mashma, Yom, Shilifanab Dafka, Belo Kamayamim, Akupayim, Evele Maholomar, Tuadin, Nami, Yomai, Ushusha, Vishoma, Beda. שלפי הנראה תשלומים מועיל רק לפסוקי תורה אבל הנביאים כתובים לא מדלה לא פירש מהחו וכן זכורני מזה למען רב שנשאר מורה ורבינו ועתידו שלנו הרב הגאון הנאמן שליטה שלפרנק לבי מאיר מזוז מאת ידידי הרב מרדכי בן שמעון נראו אם תמיד החם רשאי לבטל מקריאת חוק לישראל אוקיי so they say because I remember a while back okay or quite a while back okay A long while back, that Rabbi Mazuz was asked a question by my friend Rabbi Mordechai ben Shimon, if a Tamid Hakam is allowed to stop reading Hakriyat Chok Yisrael, ve'eshivo b'ksara, shu patur milimud mishnah v'talmud imhu Tamid Hakam she'oseg b'talmud yomom. As a Tamid Hakam, as a Hakam, because you study Gemara, you learn and you deal with the poskim, you deal with halakha, so yes, you would be exempt from studying Mishnah and Talmud. Okay, but obviously not what? Torah Nebim Ketubi. Ve'ata muban kevan shtikun hayom yomi besod kivi'at kivi'sod kivi'at ha'ikim ha'Torah mitbatteh ba'ikar b'pesukim perashat ha'shabu'at dafka. Ve'ata Nebim Ketubi, b'tamud, Mishnah v'kabbalah לא במפורש איזה פרקי נביאים כתובים ואיזה מסכת משנה ותלמוד וקבלה אלא שנהגו לקרוא נביאים כתובים מסדר הפטרה של השבוע שזה קרוב לעניין תיקון קריאת המקרא אבל שאר הלימודים התקינו לפי ראות עיניהם you see what I mean? That's just the way they saw it to do לפי ראות עיניהם של חכמי הדורות בימיהם What they established as the readings of the day, that's just the way they saw things when they established them. He doesn't seem to be saying that there's any true meaning behind it or truth or a sword for it. Nimsa she'ikar tikun shel Rabbeinu Ha'ari shehu sorech nefesh ruach hakshara shel ha'adam mitbatteh b'miyuhad b'pesukei mikra b'miyuhad ובוודאי שמונה רבינו מתכוון כך באומרו שפטור מלימוד משנה ותלמוד כיוון שהוא עוסק בהם כל היום. ואחרי הנאמרת צריך לקבוע עת ללמוד נביאים כתובים קבלה מוסר שלא יגרע מסדיק כמה רגעים ללמוד מוסר להתעורר ולשים נפשו בכפו. וכבר כתב מרן חידה על כל לימוד
חוק לישראל
yeah, I guess makes sense וכבר כתב מרן חידה על כל לימוד חוק לישראל כי הוא סדר נאה דרך כסרה וכשאלה וזוכה במעט זמן לקרוא תורה נמכתובים לשום משנה וגמרה בזוהר והאיש יראה חוק נתב לו יעבור כי הוא תועלת עשו נלשו כי הנמנה הזאת נעומי bottom line is He goes back to the same thing. Why lose out on it? The whole thing takes a few minutes. You're covering all your ground. Yes, the ikar is what? Is the mikra. And if you're a hacham, that you're studying Gemara and Poskim all day long, so yes, you don't need to read the Mishnah and Gemara portion. So, okay. You want to sit with the people, read the Torah and the Bibliothek, and you want to get them off the table. But go to the table for another 3 minutes. Just stay there and finish it. Okay, after that he's getting into the other pesukim for the other, you know, for the Thursday night and stuff. We're not going to touch any of that, and we're not going to look at the sikkum at the end. So we're finished with Rabbi Yitzhak Barda. The next section goes to Yalkut Yosef. Okay, there's a lot to read on the bottoms. We're not going to read it. We're not even going to read the first few pages, but I think we should come back to it another week. I just want you to see page Shin Lamed Bet of Yalkut Yosef.
Does it say to say it or not to say it?
Look at Shin Lamed Bet. We're going to see it right now. You got it, Dave? Ralph, you got it? Mark, you got it? Verse ready? Tamid Hacham, Obin Yeshiva, Halumed Bechol Hayom Besed Limud Shelo, Eino Sarich Lekro Chok Yisrael. That's it. Umikom Makom, Tov Benachon Shegam Ben Yeshiva Yikba'a Limud Chok Yisrael, Ben Asedarim Ben Yeshiva, B'Sha'a She'eino Lomed Gemara Poskim. So what do you say? A Tamid Hacham, or a quote-unquote yeshiva student that learns all day his set learning, whatever his, you know, daily routine of learning is, he does not need to read Halak. But in any case, it's nice, it's proper, it's good. That even the yeshiva student should establish for himself a set time of reading Halak Yisrael. But when do it? Do it. You know, between sessions. Okay, I have a 5-minute break between this class and that class. You know, or before lunch or something like that. When you're at a time that you wouldn't be learning Gemara or Poskim, okay, so read the Halak. It's like, he crashed it.
It really, and he says the word, by choosing the words Eno Sarih, right, as opposed to Eno Hayav, it's like he's really
trying. Yeah, you don't have to.
Stopping the question.
Yeah. So if you don't need to do it, it's not for you guys.
Well,
you guys
another, are doing boom.
A lot more.
He's making like the Halak is for the Amharis. It's for the guy who's
not even for the Amharis. He's not even making for the Amharis. Okay, we're going to come back. We have to read these three pages in the entirety. But I want to skip it for now. I just want to cover a few more things. Now look, the next page, Pehet, is all the Sion. Mm-hmm. Okay, which is one of David Batesh's friends. Right, David?
Mm-hmm.
Who's all the Sion?
Maybe that's there.
No.
No.
You're sleeping there with your phone. Come on, that big book that Richie D. Jamal got you. So you looking at?
Huh?
Rabbi Ben Sion Abba.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
More modern, okay.
Very modern, yeah, yeah.
His brother-in-law?
Yeah.
His brother-in-law, Richie, yeah.
He likes him?
He loves him.
Of course he loves him.
Why?
Married to his sister, what do you mean?
Mm-hmm.
No, that's not what I'm asking.
No, he got his sister out of the house, got an extra bedroom for him, next.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, I think he's a fan of...
That's it, Sheila. Haim Talmidei HaChamim Serichim Afhim L'mod Chokli Yisrael Bechol Yom. Okay, here's the question: do Talmidei HaChamim have to study Chok every day? Teshuvah. Af Talmidei HaChamim Halomdim Kol Hayom Sirichim L'mod Chokli Yisrael Bechol Yom. Umikom Akom Dai Sheikru Torah Nevi'im Uktubim Kifi Shemisudah Sham Umishna Ahat Me'oto Stedet V'chein Ket Azohar V'edai Bekach. So what are they telling over here? Yes, they do have to read it. But they can suffice by just reading the Torah and the Miktubim, okay? And in the Mishnah, they can just read one Mishnah. They could skip the Gemara, because that's all they're doing all day long anyway. And then let them read that small paragraph of Zohar. And that's enough. But still, he's saying, Sirichim, they have to. Okay? Oh, yeah? And mentioned about Shaul. Basically contemporaries, right? Yes. Both Porat Yosef guys.
Yes.
Both big figures in Yerushalayim. What's going on? Again, you're looking at the Zohar world and the non-Zohar world.
What does Rabbi Shaul say?
He doesn't really discuss this in any of his writings as far as I've seen so far.
Have you spoken to him about?
I did not speak to him about it so far.
And when's Sam going to call him to find out?
I don't know. Sam, let us know. Okay? Again, we need to read what he writes on the bottom, but we're going to come back to it. Okay? I just want to go... We're going to skip further ahead again. Now, Hachem David Yus, because I know, I see some of you guys want to kiss already for the night. So I just want to jump to certain areas.
Where are you going?
The next book. Just turn the page. Yes. Good. The next section is from Rabbi David Yosef. Rabbi David Yosef recently wrote, and he's still writing, a set of books called Halakha Birura. It's going to be when it finishes. God only knows how many pages, how many volumes. Son, I'm David Yosef. Yeah, David, you know.
Yeah.
Halakha Birura. Multi-volume work, still in the process. So far, there's at least a dozen volumes out, and he's not even a third finished with Orah Hayim. Okay? He takes every halakha from Shuharu, writes it out, and then writes other things on it, and then sources on it, and then sources on sources. Okay? So it's a really all-encompassing work, which gets too tiresome at times, but on the same point, it's very good because he covers the gamut with sources. You have a lot of things to look into, and even if he doesn't like something, he at least mentions it in passing. He doesn't tell you what they say. He makes you think they're saying what he's saying, but they aren't always doing that, but at least you found another source that you can look into. So look Shaharu on top. Like we read before, Ahar sheyaseh min bet kneset yelech le bet midrash veyigba et lmod veSarich sheoto et yeh kabua shelo yaberenu af imhu sabu leharbiyah harbe. Okay, exactly what we read before. That was page 1. Then you got page 2, page 3. Okay, page 4. Get to page 5. See page 5? Okay. Then the second line says, Seder halimud l'kubaywa l'kubaywa itim l'tura. Okay. You got everybody right here? Okay. The order of learning to establish times for Torah. Dalit. Ba'ale batim. Okay. So here's your common folk now. Slowly people over here. Ba'alei batim she'enam yichulim la'asok b'Torah kol hayom. They're not able to toil in Torah the entire day. V'kubayim itim l'limud Torah b'meshach sha'atayim u'shelosh shorot b'chol yom. And they establish for themselves time to learn Torah 2 to 3 hours every day. Ra'ui lahem she'egishu et zeman limudam lahalakha lema'aseh mituach shuharuch v'nosei kelev. It's good for them to sanctify the time of their learning to learn halakha lema'aseh, practical halakha, from Shuharuch and from its accompanying commentaries. Or from the words of our rabbis that are posek halakha, through which we live. So they will know what to do with every moment of their life according to halakha. Veloi kashelu halila vehas beisurim habayim mehamat hosei yidiat halakha. And so they do not stumble and fall because of following forbidden acts that they are unaware of because they never learned halakha. Ubevadai. Now watch this. Sheadif laasot ken. And it's better for them to study halakha and ma'aseh that I'm talking about than for them to study Talmud and Rishonim. Or for them to even study Daf Yomi is no good. Because that does not give them the opportunity to know bottom line practical halakha. Nice, right? וכן ראוי להם שילמדו בספרי מוסר. Okay, well, listen, he's being honest, at least.
Right.
Yeah, also, though, it's good for them to study works of ethics, of Musar.
Mm-hmm.
Now, look what he says. V'yesh halomdim devaryom biyomo b'seder halimud asher b'sefer chok l'Yisrael. Those that study on a regular daily basis. Yeah, the order that's found in that book, what do we call it? Oh yeah, quote unquote, Chok L'Yisrael, there it is. She knows that Peter Ben Ha'ari was established according to the Ari. ויש בו תורה, נביאים, וכתובים, ומשנה, וגמרא, וזוהר הקדוש, ומוסר והלכות. And you find all these things over there. And he ends it. But then he goes to the next page. Why is that it? But he ends it like he just, okay, finish. ואם אפשר הדבר, ילמדו הסדר הנזכר לעיל, and if it's possible, let them learn all those things that we mentioned from the Hawk. בסבתה, they'll learn it as a group. אם תמיד חכם, with a חכם, שיבאר להם להם שהלימוד במשנה וגמרא והלכות כראוי. They explain to him what's going on in the משנה, the גמרא, and the הלכות. Alright, then he goes to something else after that. So he knocked Daf Yomi, and he knocked Chok. He just wants people to study what? Halakha. All right. Now, obviously, he wrote more, and we really need to come back and study more of what he wrote.
I think you got to redo this.
Yeah, we're going to.
Yeah.
And we're going to go from this. And from this, I'm using this as a springboard to something else. I already have that planned.